Hi, let us learn how to create this cool looking title animation in this video. Recently, I attended a workshop on options as we trade in derivatives. The opening slide had the image of Namaste, which said welcome to options workshop. And naturally, I was a bit curious to know how the slide would look if I were to add some custom animation to it. And the result is what you've seen just now. Let me show you how to create this very simple yet nice looking animation from scratch. The first thing you need to create this animation is the image of a hand that looks like this. Of course, you can buy this image from any number of sources. When you go to Google, you can see that there are options available in Shutterstock. We have iStock Photo. There are options available in FreePic. There are n number of sites that offer this kind of an image. You can always pick one. The first step is to make a duplicate of this image to create the Namaste pose. So let us select this, press Ctrl D and flip it. So let us go to Arrange and then go to Rotate and say Flip Horizontal. And then you move it and keep it right next to the previous one, and that creates the Namaste pose. Now let us write the text which says welcome to, and then the name of your workshop or the name of your training program. So I'm going to just pick up the text from the previous one because I don't really want to waste your time showing you how to do this. Now I'm going to paste it over here. Now let us add the animation that makes this slide really come to life. The first thing I'm going to do is to have this come on scene. So let us have a very simple wipe animation that goes from left. Next, we need to have these two hands come up to complete the Namaste pose. So let us select this, and let us have them come in with a simple float-in animation. Once again, I can go here and choose the float-in animation in the Animations tab. Now they are in. Now this needs to happen after previous. So I'm going to say after previous. Let me click on Animation Pane so you can clearly follow what I'm doing here. Now we need to ensure that both these hands come simultaneously. So let me select the second instance of the animation and say this happens with previous. So we have welcome to, and then we have the Namaste happening. Excellent. Next, we need to have these two hands moving in the opposite direction, creating space for our title. So let me select this hand here. Then I go to add animation. Since we already have one animation on this object already, we need to choose add animation to add additional animations on the same object. So let us go here and say motion paths, and the default direction of movement is down. So let us go to effect options and say right. Now we need to move this just so that they actually cover this title. So I'm going to click on the end point of this animation, hold the shift button down and move it ever so slightly like this, so it is right outside the title. Now I'm going to have this happen with previous, but then I need to have this with a bit of delay because I want the audience to see this Namaste for a little bit. So let me say this, maybe for 1 second you can have this pose and then the hands move. Now we have this hand moving. Now let us do the same thing for the other hand as well. So let me select this, add animation, motion paths, and say to the left. And once again, as I mentioned earlier, adjust the length so that it covers the entire title. Now that looks good. Now this also happens with previous. Now to add a bit of drama, let us add some bounce effect to these two animations. So let us select both these animation events, click on the drop-down menu, go to effect options, and here you'll see the option for bounce end. So let us move this somewhere to the center and say okay. So the movement is a bit dramatic. Now while these two hands move away, we need to have the title shown. So I'm going to select this and use a simple split animation. I can see that here, and the split needs to happen vertical out. So this is the animation, and it needs to have a similar duration to the previous animation. So I'm going to have this to say around 2 seconds, which is the duration of the previous one, and we say with previous. Now if you want to send this back, you can do so. Right click and send this to back. Now this is the sequence of animation. Let us see how the whole thing plays. When I click on it, you can see welcome to, and the Namaste happens, and then we have the title revealed. Now, if you want the Namaste to stay a little bit longer, you can always have this one happening with a further delay of say around 2 seconds, and then you can say this happens with previous, and then this also needs to happen with previous. Now, when I go to slideshow, when I click, you can see that the Namaste pose stays on for a bit, and then we have the title revealed. Now, the point of this tutorial is not just to show you how to do this animation in particular. It is more about triggering some thoughts in your mind about how to convert boring, static-looking slides into vibrant, animated slides. Once you understand the custom animation options in PowerPoint intuitively, you will automatically come up with a whole bunch of creative options for yourself. To help you move in that direction, we have put together a small playlist of useful animation tricks. All you need to do is to just click on this playlist and start watching the videos one after another and practice the skill. Soon, you will be able to understand custom animation and create slides like this quite effortlessly. So go ahead, click on the link and start watching the playlist right now.